Hi friends, in this video we'll discuss about the Tomcat initialization process. Some of the students are asking, Ratan sir, how to install the Tomcat? Can you please give me some suggestions or not? Just initialization process very easy. Just you can go to the Google. So don't copy the data from others. Whenever you are trying to install the so-and-so software, try to download the software, try to install the software. Just I want a Tomcat, simply can go to the Tomcat downloader. The present version of Tomcat is the Tomcat 9 version. At least in your machine, you can go with the Tomcat 8, right? 8.5 otherwise. Just click on the Tomcat. Here directly, you'll get the download versions here. So very easy process. Simply click on Tomcat 8. If you install 9 also, no problem. I can go with the 8.5. So while installation of the files, always you have to download the service installers here. This is nothing but exe files. So here we have 32-bit and 64-bit Windows service installer, right? If 9.0 is now not a problem, just version is changed here. The remaining process is same, right? I think I clicked on API documentation. Just you can go to the download option, 9th version. Just click on here, service installer is there. This is 9th version. Which version you want, just you click on download option. Once you click download, download is automatically started, right? That's it. So downloading process also completed here. This is my download here. Yes or no? That's all. Once the download is completed, so where is the default location of the download here? In downloads. In the downloads in my system, 9 is there, 8.5 is there. Anyway, let me go with the 8.5 initialization process. So just to initialization, just double click. Click on S. So simply click on next. I agree. So here we have the two checkboxes, right? What are checkboxes here? Host manager and examples. Come on, we have the two checkboxes, host manager and examples, right? See, once you check these checkboxes, then only you'll get the support of JSTL. See, after JSP classes, we have the JSTL, Java Standard Tag Library. To get the support of JSTL, just click on the checkboxes. Then simply click on next button. So here we have the port number, server shutdown port number, AGB port number, HD port number. But we require the HD port number. See, in 8080, in your system, Oracle process is already running on 8080. The reason, just to change the port number, any 4-digit number. So like 999, 48s or 1010, 9090. You can give any port number, not a problem. Clear? That's it. Next one is the username and password. You have to give the username and password. See, once the Tomcat initialization is done, I want to deploy my application to server, right? While deploying the application, while accessing the application from the server, we require the server username and password. This is the username and password to give the servers, right? Just you can give the Tomcat and Tomcat. Yes or no? Tomcat and Tomcat. Click on next button. Click on next button. So one student is asked this question actually. Ratan sir, in my system Tomcat is not installing properly. Then I said bring the laptop. So he came with the laptop. Then he is trying to do the installation. When come to this place, in his mission, there is no Java software. Sir, no, sometimes it happens. So that student laptop, there is no Java software. If there is no Java software, it's working or not working here? Not working. So in your mission, first of all, can please try to install the Java, then you can install the Tomcat, right? Click on next button. Click on install button. Then installation process completed here, successfully. Installation process is doing. I'll show some more information regarding this Tomcat. Just run Apache Tomcat show doc. I don't want immediate process. I want run manually. So if you check this one, what happened? Internet is running, but I don't want internal running process. I want start the Tomcat manually. Then simply click on finish button. So Tomcat is installed here. Once the Tomcat installation process is done, what the default location, local disk C, program files, we have the Apache Tomcat. We have the Tomcat 8.5, right? The Tomcat 8.5, you'll get these folders here. You'll get these folders. To check your Tomcat is working properly or not, you can go with the bin folder. Bin folder contains binary executables to start and stop the server. Just let me go to the bin folder, Tomcat ADXE file. Simply can run it. Once, if initialization is done properly under proper configurations, just the server startup in so and so milliseconds. Here you will get the port number, HTTP NIO, right? New IO. NIO is represent a new input output, 9999, right? Just to connect with the server, just open the command prompt, type the URL pattern. What the URL pattern here? HTTP colon slashes. My server is there in the same machine, so we can go with the local host. But the port number is 9999. Just to click on enter button. Then you will get the message, right? Once your server is started properly, you will get this information. Ratan sir, my server is, some cases when we install, server is blinking, right? Server is blinking. When the server is blinking, then you can decide the server is not working properly in your machine. Server is not working properly in your machine, right? That's all. So not working properly in the sense, just you have to download zip files. See, most of the students, they downloaded zip files, they are trying to run, maybe mismatches. That reason what I am saying, try to download the service installer exe files, click on exe files, run the application. Sir, no, yeah, that is a better process actually. Good. So here we have the manager app, right? Just click on manager app to access the application. See, whatever the application you deployed, those applications are goes to manager app, just to give the username and password. At the time of installation, I given username and password, right? Tomcat and Tomcat. Click on sign in, right? Then what happened here? You will get the message like this. Like whatever the applications you deployed, those applications are come to this place, right? That's all. This is the way how to start the server and how to connect with the server, right? That's all, guys. And one more student is asked one more question. Ratan sir, I installed Tomcat, but unfortunately I given 8080 port number. I want to change the port number. If you want to change the port number, simply can go in the config folder here. In the config folder, we have the server.xml file. This is server.xml file. Just right click, edit plus. So here you can check it. You have the multiple port numbers are there. This is the port number. You require a HTTP port number here. What is the HTTP port number here? 1.1.9999, right? Here you can change to any 4-digit number, 8888. Just you can save it. In my local disk, see access denied. Just you can, in your system, it may allowed or may not. In that case, what you will do? Copy this file into some local disk DEF, do the modification, paste here. There's not a problem. Clear? This is a way how to change the port number. And one of the student is asked one more question. Ratan sir, I forgot username passwords. Generally, what the students will do here, generally once you forgot username password, then what you will do? Simply you are saying, Ratan sir, we will uninstall and install, right? Sir, no, yeah, we uninstall and install, but not required. And you can check the username and password also. This is called Tomcat users. You can check the Tomcat users, edit plus. Then you know what the message you'll get? Here, this is the username and this is the password. Sir, no, yeah, Tomcat username and Tomcat password, right? That's all. Clear? So if anyone is forgot the username and password, tomcat-user.xml. If anyone is forgot the port number, server.xml. This is called config folder. Lib folder contains predefined support jar files. So let-api is a predefined jar, right? That's all. What about logs folder? When the server is started, when the server is stopped, and the error is generated, log files. Temporary files, temp folder. Web apps is the main folder here. You are deploying the application to server means deploy the application to web apps folder only. So the web apps contains what? Simply can say web applications, right? That's it. What about work folder, last folder? Come into work folder. Actually, server will execute servlets, right? Okay. What about JSP here? What about JSP? Come into the JSP here. JSPs are directly not executed. Every JSP, whenever we are sending the request to the JSP is internally converted to which format? Servlet format, right? That converted servlet will be executed, then only you'll get the response. Then what I'm saying here, if the JSPs are directly not executed, those JSPs are internally converted to which format? Servlet format, right? Those converted servlets will be stored in the work folder. Wait, those converted servlets will be stored in which folder? Yeah? Work folder, right? That's all. So that's all, guys. This is all about your Tomcat installation process. Changing the username and passwords. So thanks, guys. Thanks for watching. So can please like the video and comment the video and share your information to your friends. Yeah, your friends are struggling to download the process and installation process, right? Just share the information to your friends and subscribe to our channel to get the more updates. Thank you guys. Bye.